Yo, what's up, everyone? This is Alex from Kendama OSC, and we're here today with the amazing Christian Frazier.
What's up?
Oh yeah. Okay.
So we're good to go.
Oh, what's that? Oh, sorry. That happens every live stream. I always forget to mute my YouTube page. I think there's only been one time where I haven't made that mistake yet. Anyway.
Your video's still off.
Oh, really?
If that matters.
How about now?
Nothing.
Weird. Well, I guess I can see you, so I guess that's good enough.
Yeah.
Anyway. So, Mr. Frazier, how are you doing today?
I'm good. Texting Max Norcross, talking MKO details.
Oh, yeah.
Exciting stuff going down.
Tell us a little bit about that.
I can't. I mean, the most I know right now is November 1st, Mall of America, Minneapolis, Minnesota, or I guess Bloomington, Minnesota, if we are getting technical. I mean, Mall of America is kind of a big deal. We're in the Rotunda. This is like 3 or 4 level, like kind of open area. Tons of exposure for Kendama. Going to be a lot of fun. You got people coming from all over the world. I think Tomatsu will be there. Some of the Chrome guys will be there. I'm sure Kendama USA is coming. Most of our team should be there. Wase, I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. Hopefully a bunch of the homegrown members. Should be pretty awesome. I'm stoked.
That'd be awesome if Wase could go.
Yeah, I mean, he is way cooler than anyone would ever think he was. I mean, I guess I'd Skyped with him a bunch of times before I met him, and he was really cool, but in person, he's just awesome. Really
cool. That's nice. That's exciting, though. I mean, I wish I could make it out to MKO, but money.
True. Money is something. I got none of it.
Anyway, so we actually have a lot of questions on our Instagram page. So, kale.exe on Instagram says, life outside of Kendama?
Oh, that's super easy. I'm an architecture student, so I do that all the time, like nonstop. I got like pencils right here. I guess that proves it, I guess. Maybe not. I got something, though.
Ooh. It's a poster.
It's kind of cool. It's a kid in a box. It's for my thesis. So. Yeah, I mean, I spend all my time in my architecture studio drawing, making models, doing diagrams, thinking, writing, lots of stuff. I play a bunch of Kendama in there. It's really nice. I've gotten a handful of people into Kendama in my studio, and it's cool just because it's that thing I actually get to do if I need to take a break or relax or working too much. So I always still get to play because I know a lot of the pros are busy, like, and they don't have a lot of time for Kendama, but myself, I'm very fortunate to be able to do it all the time. So it's great.
That's awesome, man. Woo! Max Norcross says, why are you so godly at release tricks?
Why is Max so cool at everything? That's the better question.
Oh. Hear that, Max?
Hope he did. Hopefully he texted you that.
Jake Fisher, why do you smell?
I don't want to talk about it. Jake knows a lot, and we'll move on. Now, Jake's an awesome dude. I think Jake's coming to MKO.
Oh,
be cool, because he's really good. That's terrifying, but he's an awesome little dude. He's not too little anymore. He's getting older. Yeah. But Max, I guess Max's question, I just do spacewalks and all that stuff a bunch. I do it all the time. Like, when I'm not even thinking about it, I'm, like, talking to people, I'm just doing it. So it's just second nature at this point. I'm just like a lot of people. Like, Chaz is incredibly good at gunslingers, and to him, that's just the normal go-to thing he always does. So everyone has their thing. I just like throwing my Kendama in the air.
Woo! Very nice. who is your favorite non-sponsored player? That's hard.
Who's non-sponsored?
Alex Sirota, of course. I mean, I don't know. There's a lot of really good kids out there. It's, I can't think of like who's like not sponsored.
Yeah, it's tough. I'm having a hard time as well. And I'm one of the kids.
I mean, Luke Ford's an awesome dude. He's really good. I guess he's not sponsored. He's still a really good dude. I mean, all the guys, tons of guys in Washington are just ridiculous and really cool guys. Not all of them are sponsored.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I know the person, Matt Nix. He is like, he lives in, he's English. He lives in Britain or whatever you want to call it. He's been playing Kanama longer than I have, longer than most people have, and he's incredible. Go on the YouTube and search like Kendama TTY, so like Kendama Matty or whatever. Matt Nix, got to meet him last year in France at the EJC. He's like one of my favorite players ever. He's in one shot in my Kendama at a 10, dude without a shirt, and he has blonde hair. But he's not sponsored, I don't think. He's one of my favorite players. He's like the, to me, he's like the British Colin Sander. Like he started it all in his own way. So, shout out Matt Nix. I'm sure he's not watching this, but that's all right.
That's really cool. Okay, and then the same person asks, and your favorite lefty player?
One of the Gallagher twins is left-handed. Who is it? It's Nick. Nick is left-handed. I hope I'm right.
I couldn't tell you. I just know that one of their voices is deeper than the other.
I think it's Nick's the one. I don't know. I haven't seen him since Tacoma, and at the time I didn't talk to him too much, so I never really get to like visualize the difference. But I'm pretty sure Nick is the left-handed one, so I'm just going to go with him.
Okay. Well, there you go. What made you decide to take your career in architecture?
Oh, I don't have a career in it yet. I'm still a student, but
yeah,
I guess what got me into it, I guess as a kid, like building Legos and building stuff's like the kind of easy way to put it. In high school, I took some of the drafting, architecture, engineering classes, and that's where I kind of like really started enjoying it, and I enjoyed like creating things. The parts I didn't know about at the time. So architecture is like half art, half science. So I was like the science kind of making things work and understanding how things go together. But the art of it is the thing I kind of learned about these past 5 years of school. So I guess I enjoy all of it. It's a chat, like architects are problem solvers, like for everything architecturally, know a lot of different things on a lot of different subjects. So it's just really cool kind of learning about tons of different things. Like I view the world like a little bit differently now, just walking anywhere, like walking inside a building, you just kind of think about what the space you're in. You think about like little details, and like if a door opens the wrong way, I'm like, well, that's not good. That's not up to fire code. Things like. But I mean, it's something. If anyone wants to ever do it in college, something you'd be very passionate about. It's not easy. It takes a lot of work. A lot of not sleeping. Like when I was my third year of college, I averaged 4 hours of sleep a night.
Dang.
That's just how it was. It's not gotten easier, but the amount of work is different at this point when I'm a fifth year. But yeah, it's fun, but it's hard.
Yeah. I mean, that sounds like an awesome thing to go into, though. I mean, like, it sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, I mean, it's fun. I mean, once you get in the real world, it's obviously different than school, but you get to work with, like, clients. You get to actually build and create things. Like, you can have your own build. I can have a building one day that maybe has my name on it. Like, oh, Christian Fraser did that. That's got to be a really cool feeling, like, knowing you drew something, then somehow it became reality. And that's just a really
super cool,
amazing thing to be a part of.
That is super, super cool, actually.
I got a long way to go. I graduate in May, which I'm stoked about. But then becoming an architect is still a whole other process after that.
Still, man. Still, it's really exciting.
Yeah.
I mean, but also you got to keep Kendama in there somewhere, too.
Oh, yeah.
You can't not play Kendama. You know I'm going to get every architect in my office to play Kendama. It's just like, easy. I went up to, when I was in Minneapolis in July, I went and visited this firm, like, tons and tons of people there. And I had, like, 56-year-old ladies playing Kendama.
Huh.
Super. It was awesome. They were all really excited about it.
That's awesome.
Just proves that Kendama really is for everyone.
Oh, yeah. No doubt about that. When did you first hear about Dama?
I was a junior in high school, so I was 16 years old. A friend of a friend is like a rollerblader, so in Atlanta and like the Southeast at the time, back in 2008, that's how Kendama got popular. Like, I mean, up in Pittsburgh, like Colin Sander and his all his friends like got Kendama through like skiing and rollerblading, kind of scene videos or whatever. And then in Atlanta, the same, like, Kendama Joe, like, that guy, he used to live in Atlanta. He played Kendama. I used to talk to him a little bit. But Chris Smith is a guy that got Kendama started, like, kind of where I lived, and he got my good friend Joey Kapansky into it. And then Joey brought it to, like, marching band practice one day, and I was like, oh, that's really stupid. And then 2 months later, so I don't know how it happened, but he got me hooked. And it's all just blown up from there. It's kind of ridiculous how far it's really gone and worldwide, and even just personally, like, never envisioned anything like what it is now. So, yeah, it's almost been, I've almost been playing for 6 years now.
Dang.
It's a long time. Makes me feel old.
Oh my gosh. That's crazy. I've only been playing for 8 months.
And the scary part is, like, some kids that are playing for, like, a year are better than me, and it's like, I don't get it. It's like a year, and they kids learn so much faster now.
Yeah,
it's awesome.
There's actual, like, games, competition now.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, when I started playing, it was just me and Joey hanging out in my basement trying to figure out new tricks. That was about a year and a half, that's all we did.
Dang.
I didn't meet anyone else that played Kendama. All right. But I thought...
If you got some questions, name them off, too.
I have one question on my Instagram from OliverJohnson13. My favorite edit. I think the favorite I've always kind of stuck by is Nicholas Schaffer from Switzerland. Dude that has all the Mugens. His, like, summer edit, like, 2010, I think. It's all just really shot well. The music's awesome. He has really – every trick's done on, like, a fresh Mugen. It's really cool. He's a cool dude to meet in person. But yeah, I mean, it's a really classic edit for me from, because it came out in 2010. That's kind of when I was really getting into it and kind of progressing a lot myself.
Very sick, very sick. Well, I'll just make this announcement now. Everyone, if you got a question for Mr. Christian Frazier, leave it in our comments on Instagram. Because for some reason, YouTube's being buggy. So, leave in our comments on Instagram, because I got the feed right open right here.
Do it.
All right.
Ready. I'll answer anything. Anything.
Anything. You heard it. You heard it right there. You answered anything. Okay. Eric asks, favorite homegrown model?
Let me look. Right now, the red, the matte red one is pretty awesome. I mean, the walnut stripe's always a classic. I'm starting to like, or I guess over the summer when I was in Japan, just the natural homegrown without a stripe, that one really grew on me. Striped homegrown is the grain goes this way in the maple, and on the regular ones it goes vertical. And the vertical one, to me, breaks in better. So, I mean, even just the natural one might be my favorite. But then I love the matte paint that's on the purple and the gold and the red. It's really nice. But then the dino leg's nice too, the translucent. Dude, they're all awesome. I can't answer that question. All awesome. I think we're in the process of, like, kind of redesigning the homegrown a little bit. Hopefully get better in any way you can think of. So
Oh.
Look out for that eventually.
I'm excited.
I don't know if I should have even said that, but here we are.
It happened already, so. Well, that's the thing that happens when you're alive. Everything you say, you can't take it back.
That is a lesson right there, man.
What is the best kendama you've ever played with?
I'm looking. All my kendamas are right here, so I'm just kind of looking at them. Let's see. You know what? I'll keep it classic. Best kendama I've ever played. It's probably this one. If you look at it, it looks like a dog toy, but it's my second kendama ever. First Azura Leaf Green. And like a bunch of my earlier years, I've shot a ton of tricks on this thing, and it was like trustworthy for like 4 years. It was like stuck in a tree for a month at one point. But like, just the original Azura is like the things I learned on. So like, to me, they're like one of the best kendamas out there. I have next to me, I have all five like original Azura colors, like brand new, just chilling. So,
dang,
I like to look at as well.
Very nice.
But those, I mean, JKA Mugens are obviously incredible to play with. I mean, I have a ton of old Sweet Kendamas that we don't make anymore just based on the crappy paint. But those still play, like, really well in a lot of ways.
That's nice.
I just love Kendama, dude. Like, I'll play with anything. All right, I got some questions on mine.
Ooh, name them off.
Favorite place to play Kendama or film? That's a good question. Like, I've been kind of like thinking about filming kendama. A lot of times filming kind of becomes a hassle because, like, oh, we got to go to the sick spot, get the sick shot. It's really hot outside and this and that. And a lot of times I just, like, kendama to me a lot of times is just hanging out in my room by myself, just like listening to music, maybe in silence, just playing kendama. So I'm in the process of kind of filming a new video. It's not like Edit 11 or anything, just a new video that I will film all, like, inside. Just kind of going back to, that's where I learned to play kendama, and that's really kind of the place that I'm most comfortable doing it in. But it's also awesome playing kendama on the beaches of Hawaii or at temples and things like that. Like, I was out today, and like this trail behind my apartment, like I found like this like sick like rock face and like creek under this bridge. So I'm like, I'm gonna go film down there soon, and that's like an awesome place to be. But in general, just where I'm comfortable. Like, I play a ton of kendama in my architecture studio, which is like concrete floors, and my kendamas get super messed up, and stuff like this happens. Every kendama I bring to studio, the bottom cup gets just messed up. All right, let me do another question off this thing.
Is your feed blowing up?
Actually, yeah, so that's cool.
I know. I got like 100 comments, like notifications. I was like, oh my god.
Yay.
Well,
what tama would you recommend on a Spider Sense grip? Is that like, I guess Spider Sense grip is like a different, I guess it's the color way on it. I don't know what it is. I don't know what colors it is.
It's anything blue, like, red, and black.
Okay.
Like the Spider-Man colors.
Yeah, yeah. I think a good one for that is the Cyan Atac is a really nice kind of blue color that I enjoy. I mean, honestly, just anything red, blue, or black. Like, I think there's a tribute ball that's blue with a red stripe, maybe.
I think so.
Like, that would look really sick on it. I don't know, just pick from one of those three colors. I mean, if you like something sticky, an Atac, if you like something not sticky, I don't know. I mean, got your options. It's red, blue, or black. Just maybe say if you have red ball, you get a black string. Or blue ball, red string. You got your options.
Yeah.
And that was from Iceberg.
Oh, that's Isaiah.
Cool. From Yelm Kendama, how do you get better at Kendama? You practice a bunch and you play. Like, people ask me how much I practice, and I say I don't practice, I just play kendama. So, just play kendama. And you get better when you play kendama with other kendama players. That's always a good way to do it.
Very true. Got some massive, like, friendship competitiveness going on with my friends right now.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely happens. But as long as you keep it positive and have fun, you're good.
Oh, yeah. I wonder what... Because one of my friends is actually coming over at 9, so I wonder, like, what his reaction is going to be if he comes in here and, like, he sees me talking to you. He's going to be like, huh, what? How?
Yeah. He'll be stoked, for sure.
That'll be something awesome to see live. Anyway, what's your favorite place you've been to because of Kendama?
Japan, for sure. I mean, that's like, the stuff we got to do in Japan this past summer is just, it was so, like, humbling, and it was just such an honor to be a part of so, like, a lot of the things. Like, we got to perform in the sacred stage in Miyajima Island. We have to go through, like, a very sacred kind of, like, ceremony. I don't know what religion is out there, but, like, something like Tamatsu was like, yeah, like, I've never even got to do this before. We're just like, wow. And we're just here on a trip. And, like, after the World Cup, we had, like, there's a sake, like, ceremony where, like, these guys brought a huge barrel of sake, and some of the guys busted it open, and Tamatsu was like, yeah, we only do that at, like, really sacred weddings and stuff. So we'd never seen that before either. So everything there was just surreal, and it was awesome. Yeah.
That's so.
Can't wait to go back.
That's so cool, man. Japan's always been like the top of my list for just places to go, like experience culture, and it's.
I mean, I wanted to do that before I played Kendama, so.
Yeah.
A dream come true.
It's crazy. What are your favorite Kendama brands overall?
I mean, Swedish Kendamas, obviously, not obviously, but I obviously love all the products we have. I mean, Gloken, all the Mugens are great. I don't know, I like all Kendamas, really. I mean, Grain Theories are awesome. What else do I got over here? Anything JKA is awesome. All the old stuff, Chrome, great stuff. I even have a bunch of, like, old, like, Chinese kendama brands that aren't made anymore that some of my favorites. But, dude, I love all kendamas. Like, that's why I have so many, because I'm like, oh, cool, new kendama. Just make a collection, and it's awesome.
You know what's crazy? This is kind of like a thought that I had. It's like, when we first interviewed you, it was for our club and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was, well, how many, that was like a couple months back.
It was like in April or something.
Yeah. That's crazy. It's been a while. Like, now the club has, like, I want to say 30 to 40 members in it.
Yeah, that's sick. You guys had like six last time.
Yeah. So it's like, it's so much stuff has changed. Kendama OC came about because of it.
Namo C is doing great things, that's for sure.
Ah, thank you. Sweets always does great things, so, you know. Anyway. Sure. That was beside the point. McJed says, thanks for the wino, Christian.
Yeah, that was... How do you say his name?
McJed.
I mean, is that it? You say McJed? Is that it?
Yeah.
Oh. You're welcome, dude. I hope you enjoy it. all right, from Bag of Chips, what is your current slaying Dama? I got a couple. Let's see here. All right, we got three setups right now. You got Homegrown Paddock with the Dark Blue Mugen Dama. You got your Jeffrey Van Reven pro model, legend model. That's a little lie.
Yeah.
He's always been my favorite kendama player, so I had to get it. And the yellow and the red goes well together. And this is a interesting one. It's a white Ozora ball with a with a Kiaki Ken, but has a homegrown seal on it just because it looks sick. But it's like perfectly balanced, plays really well. Nice kendama. And also, is next to me. The Prism Bro model, like the one of a kind.
Oh, some light on this.
There you go.
Oh, there you go. So good.
That's fun. Still breaking it in, but it's nice.
Sick. Who is your biggest inspiration?
Kanama player-wise, it's always been to me, Jeffrey and Alex out in the Netherlands. I mean, they're easily my two favorite Kanama players, and that'll probably never change. Alex's techniques and all that stuff is just perfect, and he's an incredible guy. I love hanging out with that dude. Then Jeffrey, I mean, same thing. He's done every trick you can ever think of. Like, if you say, oh, I thought of this new trick, Jeffrey probably did it 4 years ago. he's legendary to me. Like, he's the dude that I consider just, like, top of it. And he's also really fun to hang out with. He's a really cool dude. I was glad to meet him.
That's sick.
So, yeah, definitely those two.
Man. How did Sweets discover you?
Actually, I discovered Sweets, put it that way. they first had their website, like, they had a little protein page and had, like, Chaz on it and this other guy that was not on the team for very long. And they're like, yo, we need players. And so I emailed him, like, Kanama Edit 6, and then, like, 2 hours later I was on the team, so.
Nice.
like, probably the only time in history someone has sent their video to someone and gotten sponsored.
That's so accurate, though.
And that was over 4 years ago now. It was in 2010. So.
Damn.
Times have changed, though.
Still times have that definitely way. Changed.
And Sweets Kanamas was just pretty much an idea at that point. They had a website. They had, like, their Chinese painted kanamas, and those were awful. But it's grown a bunch. It's really cool to be a part of.
Yeah. See, times have changed a lot, where now kids ask Kanama OC if we can sponsor them, even though we're not even close to their company.
Yeah, that's not surprising at all. I got a question from Noah Cordova. What is your least favorite Kanama and why? All Kanamas are awesome. I mean, it's a matter of what paint it is, what wood it is, as long as it's got a string, a ball, and a ken, that's all that matters. So, as long as the people are playing Kanama, that's all that matters. So
the worst kind of that Kanama is not Kanama.
Yeah, I mean, like, if a kid gets a Yomega or Duncan Kanama, it's like, great, at least they have a Kanama in their hands.
Exactly. how much muscle have you gained playing Kanama?
None. Skinny. So
I feel you.
Maybe if I play with my boss a little bit more, I'll get there, but...
The boss.
Now, using the wrecking ball when we were out in Sacramento last summer, I got you going a little bit. I think it was heavy, but it was fun. It's a crowd pleaser, but it's definitely a workout.
Oh, yeah. It's someone's birthday, actually, on Instagram right now, and they were just like, hey, it's my birthday. Can you say happy birthday? Happy birthday, man. Have a good one.
Happy birthday, guy whose name I don't know.
Brady.
Brady, happy birthday, dude.
What is your favorite edit?
I already answered that question.
Oh, you did? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Nicholas Schaffer, Summer, Kanama Edit 10. Man, I got some friends leaving inappropriate comments on my Instagram.
I gotta see this.
I'm deleting it. It's gone, man.
Dang it. Too late.
Oh, well. I did say I would answer anything, so. But I can text him that personally if he really needs to. All right. Cal Nassar, go-to Dama that's not a Sweets. In Azuras and Mugens, pretty much. Whether it's Musou or JKA, doesn't matter, but pretty much that's what it is. I mean, I play like everything. Like, I don't know, there's a Chrome, there's a Terra down here, there's an Azura, there's a Sunrise, there's a Kanama USA Pro model, there's a Chinese Kanama. So, I'm always changing out my kendamas that I play with, like, daily, which is also a bad thing because none of them ever get broken in. Like, I'd almost rather buy a new kendama, give it to, like, some kid for a week and get it back and then play with it.
Oh, yeah. That's a good strategy, actually.
Yeah.
This is a really good question from Maya Song. Did kendama
influence awesome.
You to be the person you are today, or is it something that brings pride and joy to you?
I mean, I guess it's brought me to who I am today. I mean, kendama has brought me a lot of different opportunities and experiences, and those experiences and opportunities shape me as a person. So it's kind of a transitive property. I learned that in algebra at some point. But, like, I don't think that kendama changed me, like, directly, but things kendama has allowed me to do made me who I am. So that's a great question, Maya. Hopefully I'll come out and see you in Hawaii sometime soon, because I miss it out there. What was the second part of the question?
That was it.
Cool, as long as I answered it.
Domadair. Oh gosh, around double juggle.
No.
Yeah.
No. What does that mean? Like,
I can't juggle.
Like pull up, like double juggle cup, double juggle to big cup or small cup, double juggle to bottom cup. To... No, I can't do that. It'd take me forever.
Yeah, I can single juggle from big cup.
And I like when I do like if I do multiple juggles, it's like one and a half or two. I like doing juggling tricks where it's like you do the cup, then you flip the can like three times and go to the net and juggle that way. Not like consistently going back and forth.
Yeah.
It's not my thing.
My brain just doesn't work like that.
Yeah. I mean, I remember I started learning how to juggle at the first Tennessee battle that Chad Covington, like the Kendama Squad, hosted. Like one of the tricks was called like the Tennessee Juggle, and it was just I pull up, juggle at a big cup, and like I had to learn it for that battle, and it took me forever. And it's just it's cool how it's juggling is like kind of like the norm nowadays.
Yeah,
I couldn't do it at all.
Juggling in whirlwinds, man.
Yeah, I mean, I remember I filmed like around the whirlwind. A long time ago, I get it six or something, and that took me forever. And now kids just do it when they're bored.
Yeah, I've had to like when I started, it was all like spacewalking tricks, and then like now it's not. So it's like I got all geared up with all those spacewalking tricks, and then now as soon as I got them on point, oh, guess what? It changed.
Yeah. I try and personally stay on top of it. Every style that's kind of introduced.
Try and keep it versatile. What's it like being a pro?
I mean, it's pretty normal, I guess, but it's cool kind of being in the process of growing kendama on a global level. We're working with Swedish kendamas, working with other kendama players to get going, traveling, the opportunities we've been able to, the stuff we got to do. And having a pro model is cool. A toy.
Fine.
What else do we do? I don't know. I just love the pro community. Everyone's always super positive and just there because they love Kendama.
That's how to do it. ooh, this is a cool question. What should an edit consist of?
That's a good question because it's changed. When I started making edits, it was like, film. 20 tricks in your room. Edit it with a song on YouTube. Now, videos, personal lifestyle, setting the vibe for the video itself, having awesome tricks, hopefully multiple angles, shots, kind of showing off where you are, doing things that are also not kendama related. A lot of the goals with Kanawa videos,
are promoting the lifestyle that Go see with.
Like
showing that
and just Kendama is a whole lifestyle.
It's a whole bunch of
cool things.
Cool things
with Kendama.
With Kendama in your life.
So.
Good question. Sure. Way to put it.
It's like my music with bangers, tricks. Me, that's just kind of how long all this stuff. A lot of videos now are just 100%. Everyone's got their own style.
I feel ya. What made you choose your pro mod color? Like, is it your favorite color, or is it just like, you know?
So I remember when I chose it.
We were me and Chaz were in the shop.
Like December 2012. Just doing chameleon.
Then I got a chameleon.
And I was like, dude, Chaz, what if this was a pro mod?
That'd be great.
Then we had to get choose the colors for the chameleon. So we showed us the website. And from it, went on there,
found
actual colors called Radbear.
I need it.
I hadn't. The one I didn't know was the kind of darker, just the wine. The maroonish.
Nothing was with it. I thought it was pretty unique.
The first folk actually had. A long time ago, it was actually maroon with a white hole. That was part of my inspiration. But I also always looked at red with a red.
Very nice. Question for me. When will you start selling Damas, Alex? Probably never, because that's not our thing. We're not really looking to do that type of thing. We're the people that connect everyone, I guess you could say, and just kind of play and just have you guys watch, I guess. A content creator, not really anything with, like, you know, money or anything like that. You know, I just like being the middle guy. You have any questions?
Jack Gallagher's my audio is repeating. It is repeating on my iPad.
It's repeating?
Yeah. Is it coming out of your speaker?
I don't know. I can get headphones.
I would try.
Although I don't know where they are. While I go look for my headphones, Christian, would you like to lace a banger?
Yeah, for sure. I don't know about landing a choice. No. Should probably land it.
Lace. Let's see. Well, I hope this is better.
Is it working now?
I think it's good.
Yeah, I don't hear myself repeating, so.
Yay!
Good looking, Nick. I think that was Nick. Cool.
Okay. You got any more questions?
Yeah, I got a bunch. But where did Gabe Youngstrom asked, where did you first see Kendama? It was in marching band practice in high school. First time I saw my friend with it, and I thought it was stupid. I got into it about a month later. Mark.7 asks, is the homegrown maple worth the money? Absolutely. These Kendamas are really durable. They're really balanced. They play really well. I highly recommend it. Bag of Chips asked me to show my glass case.
So I should probably get
next to me. Can I turn my camera around? Nope. Sure.
There you go.
Let's get it sent.
Hold on. Do you see that? There you go. Got pro models. Kind of got your daily stuff. These are all old sweet stuff, old pro models, old marbles, frost stuff, more kind of daily stuff. You got your JKA Mugens, nine color. Got the stickers to go along with it. Thanks to Chad Covington. Shout out to him. Got all the Musos, all nine of them. I think there's nine colors right now. One from Japan. You got five original Azuras. You got your yellow Azura. You got the rest of the JKA seals that are in the back and all black Tamas. And you got kind of your special ones, your Emperor Bilbo Ket, Vudam, all the small ones, Rolling Pin, Pill, Takayo, Five Cup, Stove, all the cool little fun stuff. And up here, got some artist stuff, a little tiny stuff from Japan, some other Dewi Kendamas. I got a pro model, old pro model, Terra, Chrome, got my beautiful girlfriend, and then my boss, and my fish bag. Fish bag is like Pride and Joy from Japan.
The fish bag, no.
Thanks to Hajime for that. Dang. Actually, thanks to Hajime's wife. She's the one that makes them.
That's really cool. All
right.
Do you have brothers or sisters? And if so,
yeah, I have an older brother named Zach. How old is he? He's 25. He lives around here. I gave him a Kendama like a few months ago. He never wanted one until now, which is weird. But yeah, he does his own thing.
Cool.
What else we got? Where do you think you would be without Kendama? From Carrie Kia. I have no idea. I guess I'd be more into school or doing some other activity. I don't know. That's a great question. I mean, it's hard to imagine my life at this point without Kendama at all. So, good question. Mark7 asks, what do you do besides Kendama? Pretty much just work in studio for my school. I'm in college, about to graduate. Always doing that. I got a few more of them. Let me just knock through them. What Dom, do you think I should get this decently priced? Any Azura is good, any Focus, the kind of the basic stuff. And Tributes are a good price, Zens are a good price. No, I mean, any of the kind of $20, $25 Kendamas are perfect. Got a Domadair, Kenflip, Lake Kenflip. Let me just do that because it's pretty easy.
Here we go. Dun, 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 dun.
That's from Cal Nassar that I do the first time.
Oh,
first try. That was cool.
Least.
From Shannon. How do you say those names? Nguyen. I don't know. What makes a good Kendama player? To me, just try and learn a lot of tricks. Get good at some stuff and always challenge yourself to be learning new tricks. Just have fun. That's really what you all gotta do. As long as you're having fun while playing Kendama, you're doing it right. Cool. Alright, what you got on your question?
Describe the word professional Kendama player.
To me, professional Kendama players, we're role models for Kendama players in general, like kids. Just someone that exists to represent the sport and the idea of Kendama. I mean, Kendama is whatever you want it to be, and I think the pros kind of embody that idea. Because Kendama is what you want it to be, so all the pros kind of show that in their own ways. But right. I always try to keep, uphold myself to, as a role, I guess a role model, I always hold myself to higher standards, making sure I'm someone kids can look up to. Maybe kids don't look up to me. I don't know. But try.
I look up to you, Christian.
Well, thanks, Alex.
Yeah.
Bag of Chips said, legit mind blown. It's probably the trick I did. Brad Dennis, can you show us your abs? Oh, dude, I would if I had some, for sure.
Dude, the abdominals.
If TJ was here, I'd love to, like, put my head in front of his. So then, yeah, that's me. Mark 7, I'm supposed to shout out to him. Shout out, Mark.
Woo!
My Facebook or my Instagram's still blowing up.
Yeah, samesies.
All right, you go with some of yours.
What does your pro model symbolize, like the insignia on it?
Oh yeah, so it is it's an architecture thing. It's like a 9-square grid if you look at it as a cube. So to me that means, I mean, it's, you can look up this guy named Peter Eisenman and you can read about him if you want. That's where it comes from. But the 9-square grid to me is about something that you can look at, and it's much more than it is on face value. I mean, it could be a hexagon, it could be a bunch of triangles, it could be a cube, it could be 10 cubes, it could be 27 cubes. And to me, that relates to Kendama, because Kendama isn't just what you see at face value. There's much, much more to it, whether it be the different tricks you can do, whether it be how you use it in your life or the experiences it can bring you. It's just, I don't know, it means a lot of things. I guess, let me see what my box says. It says it on the back. I haven't read it in a while. Kendama is infinitely exploratory through tricks, design, and interaction. And that defines my levels of my personal, social, and spiritual life that is Kendama. Kendama is just deep in a lot of ways, and my profession as an architecture student is deep in a lot of ways. So just always looking at things like further at different levels. Hopefully that answers your question. Yeah.
That was a really good answer.
Yeah. It's also my, I'm in a architecture fraternity, and this is like the symbol we use. It's a little different, but so.
Cool.
It means a lot to me that way, too. I'm going to leave this here. I just like looking at it.
Woo! Product placement.
Go buy a pro model. They're really nice.
They are really nice. Oh, dang it, my Willy P is not here. Oh well. What's your best trick in Kendama?
There's a few I consider like the one of the best ones I've done. I mean, one of the hardest ones is the spike, whirlwind. Spike, that was really hard. I did Borders Balance throw to bird at one point. That was pretty cool.
That pro edit.
Yeah, that pro edit. What else? I haven't filmed a bunch lately. I'm trying to think of what we filmed in Japan. A lot of the tricks in the Hawaii edit were pretty cool at the time. Still cool. I was really excited about those. Yeah, I mean, any spacewalk trick, I always enjoy and try and push spacewalk tricks to their limits. So, yeah, the few tricks, like, the last couple tricks in Edit 10 are probably the hardest ones I've done.
Huh. Yeah, all the tricks in the Hawaii were crazy. I was like, what is going on?
Yeah, we had a lot of fun. Like, it was a bunch of stuff we filmed. And there's still a lot of tricks that we're missing, too.
Huh. Hawaii Edit 2.0?
Probably not, unless we go back, which we should someday.
Throw back.
All right. What else we got? What's your favorite JK and Mugen? Probably both of these. It's a tie. Yeah. Wine.
Cool.
Pretty much brand new. I mean, I got them, they were brand new. But this thing is like one of the stickiest kendamas I own, which is incredible. And the wine is just beautiful, obviously. I don't play this at all. I play this a little bit. I haven't had a good reason to really play it a bunch yet, but
one day. So beautiful.
I do a trick on it. So.
Yeah.
Better time. No better time than now, I guess. Nope.
Lace.
Hey, there we go.
Hey, that's it. That's it. So good.
And it really is that sticky. I think it's a JK Kanama. It's pretty nuts.
Sick. Someone asks, how old are you?
I'm 22. So.
He's feeling 22.
Not that old. I feel old the more I talk to sound players, but. Still young at heart.
Oh, yes. And this is another interesting question, actually. What can be done to keep Kendama growing?
We're actually addressing a lot of this stuff right now in a lot of ways. But to me, things that keeps Kendama growing is keeping it a positive thing in every aspect. And also keeping kids engaged by constantly challenging them. Referencing, like, I did karate for, like, 7 years. I got to a point I was, like, a second-degree black belt, and I stopped learning things. Like, I'm bored. And kids have really short attention spans, so once they stop learning, they get bored and they want to move on. So how do you keep kids constantly learning about kendama, learning new tricks, and always challenging themselves? So that's the way to do it, I think. It's positive playing and constant challenging, for sure.
Oh, yeah. Also, new things. New things are nice.
Yeah, I mean, we're working on a lot of really cool stuff. I mean,
it's kind of interesting. Ooh. That's exciting.
It's a lot of work, but it's definitely exciting.
Open World Kendama. Hi, homies. They ask, what instrument did you use to play in band?
Oh, that's easy. I got a drum head right here.
Woo!
I played percussion in high school, in middle school and high school. And so in marching band when I was a freshman, I marched the second bass drum, second smallest one. But then I played snare drum. I marched snare drum for 3 years. I was like drum captain, all that stuff. That's sticks and stuff. Right here. Practice pad, always necessary. But like in my school, our percussion program was very about being well-rounded, so I could play any percussion instrument. Played timpani a bunch, a lot of fun. Any of the keyboards, marimba, xylophone, vibraphone. People always kind of like make fun of like triangle as an instrument, but triangle is one of the hardest instruments to play. And I promise you that it's not just hitting that thing. It's much, much deeper. I mean, we had like a 2-hour master class on triangle. So. Like even like crash cymbals, like the hitting two cymbals together, that is incredibly hard to do properly. I don't know. Like percussion is like the thing I did just like besides kendama. If I wasn't in architecture school, I'd be in music school for sure. So it's unfortunate I don't have much of an outlet for it now, but I always try and kind of mess around here and there.
Sick. Interesting questions here. Who will be the first astronaut to jam in space?
Probably Jake Wings, for sure.
I was thinking the exact same thing.
He's got his eyes set on the moon.
Oh, yeah.
Base lab, always. So.
One person asks, can we live stream for a long time, an all-nighter?
Well, my girlfriend sleeps, so I can probably do anything I want, I guess.
Woo!
We'll drink soda and eat candy and play video games and play kendama. Sounds perfect. Just,
like,
you guys can watch me play Destiny all night if you want.
Oh, snap, son. We could just like go off of the kendama tangent and like let's play it up.
Dude, I mean, I played video games like that was my like in middle school and a little bit of high school. I played video games all the time. But now the kendama actually made me stop. But I've gotten back into it a little bit because I'm taking some video game design classes in school right now, one of my focus studio for architecture is video game based, like incorporating architecture. So I've been playing a bunch of games lately. Destiny came out. I got an Xbox One. So
sick.
Getting back to my roots for sure.
I'm so excited. I just got the demo for Super Smash Bros. On the 3DS. Oh my gosh.
Hold on. I just had my dude Nick Gallagher say, "Spacewalk swap to handle stall. Do it." So that's a challenge.
Oh. 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 Here it is. It's happening. Oh.
Just finding good Kendama for it. Here we go. You can see.
Here it is.
Be a few tries. Second try. Get nice and close. I fell off. Oh well.
you technically still did spacewalk swap to handle.
I hope you're happy, Nick.
That was so clean.
Had a vicious Snapchat battle the other day.
Ooh.
One of them Snapchatted me. I think it was Nick. He did single, double, triple, instant jumping sticks, and I just kind of threw up a little bit.
Oh, yeah, I got that one, too. I was like, well, I'm just going to go and curl up in a little ball.
That's so hard.
Especially on a Snapchat, too.
Yeah, for sure. All right, I got some more questions on mine. Oh, Josh. Hold on. Other business, leave me alone. What percent of your collection is bought / given? Good question.
Ooh.
I mean, all the rare kendamas I paid for, obviously. I mean, even some of the old Ozuras, I mean, I bought them at the time. Some stuff I've won, some stuff even gifts. I've bought a lot of them. A lot of the Sweets kendamas I've gotten for free for the most part. Percentage-wise, I have no idea. But at this point, I've given away kind of the kendamas that aren't special, I guess. Like a lot of like just kind of regular run-of-the-mill stuff. I'd rather give to someone to play with and keep in the collection. I try and keep it all kind of like rare and nice and unique. Percent-wise, I don't know, though.
I should hook you up with one of these customs.
Custom what?
Thomas. Oh, yeah. You can't see my camera.
No, I can't.
I'll show it to you later. But the people on the live stream can see it. It's crazy.
Nice.
Yeah.
How often do you test out protos from the company?
Ooh.
And lately, not much. We're releasing a bunch of new like colors and like color sets. Like new paint-wise, nothing like right now. But things are always being developed. I know a lot of things are already being developed I can't really talk about.
But
every month or so, we usually kind of see something new and kind of mess around with it, get some feedback. So, secret stuff.
Dude, I'm stoked. I love new things. That's one of my favorite parts of Kendama, just seeing all the new stuff.
Yeah, for sure. What was your first Kendama you owned that wasn't made in the United States? Blue TK16, first Kendama ever. I mean, Kendamas were made in the U.S. until the first one was, I guess, the Kendamaco American ones they made at some point. I mean, the Homegrowns are American-made, Grand Theories are American-made. I know there was a Kendama made in America before that, but it was some off-brand, like Tom Kuhn Kendama or something. Yeah. What else we got?
Woo!
Memories from the Sweets team. Everything, dude. We had so much fun. It's not even funny. What is Max texting me? Yeah, I mean, Sweets Kendamas, we have too much fun. Specific stories, I can't even think of it. I mean, one fun thing was kind of funny. It was on video, but when we were in Hawaii, we were on this rock face, and the local dudes from Tomahawk got us like little opihi, little like mollusk-looking things, and we ate them. They were gross, but why? You got to do it. So,
Chaz
that was fun. Yeah, Chaz didn't even eat one. Like the way Thibaut edited that, it made it look like he ate one, but he didn't. So, I'm calling you out, Chaz, for sure.
Ooh. All
right. Oh, that was Max's question. Max, what's the longest time you spend in front of a camera on a certain trick? Do you take multiple sessions to complete and finally spike it? And what trick was it? That's the triple silk whip from like Edit 8. I tried filming it for like 2 months in my basement, and I probably spent 2 or 3 hours on it at some point. But when I did finally land it, it was like a 20-minute session. So now I don't put that much time into tricks like that. Like I usually land the trick off camera before I do off camera, because I don't got time for that. I can't sit in front of my camera for 3 hours. So there you go, Max. Hope you're happy.
Woo. Yeah, dude, I feel you. After spending 5 hours on around Tunbridge Wells, I'm like done with taking that much time to do a trick.
Yeah. It's rough. I mean, I always found it, I told you this, like, if you spend 3 hours on a trick, come back to it and it'll be 100% easier.
Yeah, and the next day I caught it in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I was so pissed off. I remember we were talking and I was like, ah! Exactly like that. That's the sound I made.
What's your favorite color for kendama? I like white. I like wine. Red. Or maroon, whatever you want to call it. Woo! Yellow. Pretty much these three colors. Best ones. And natty kendamas are always great.
Cannot go wrong with a natty.
Oh, do you or have you played yo-yo, and if so, how good are you? I have a yo-yo I won at Domfest last year, and I'm terrible. I wish I was better, because a lot of kendama players are really good. And I'm like, I try, but then he gets in a knot, and I'm just like, oh, well. Try quickly. Max Hall asked, Mugen or Shinzakura? Mugen? I don't know. They're both really nice. Let me get one. Where is it? So if you haven't seen the Shinzakura, it's the purple JKA seal. See, it looks a little blue on here, but it's purple for sure. It's most of them are birchwood, like TK16s. The paint, it's like kind of a TK Ozura hybrid. Really, really nice. I guess I choose Mugen's over it. Just the fact that I've only played like 2 or 3 of these, so I can't really give you a good judgment when I've played a bunch of Mugen's. So Mugen's are cool. They're cool.
What do you do when people call you gay and stupid for wasting your time with kendama? Lately, every day at school, I get those comments.
I just kind of ignore them. I'm like, oh. I'm like, cool, dude. Thanks. I'll do my own thing. I mean,
yeah.
I don't know, ignore them. It's just, they think it's stupid. To me, anyone that thinks kendama is stupid is very close-minded, because it's just a toy. Yes. What is there to hate about it? Someone thinks it's dumb, that's their problem. Just enjoy yourself and do your own thing. I mean, whoever asked that, I'm sure, is in like middle school or high school. Kids grow up eventually. Like all my friends that don't play kendama that do it around, and they respect it. They think it's cool or whatever. So, immature people, man, they're the worst.
I feel you.
Yeah, just do your own thing and be stoked that you're doing it. Don't let anyone else get to you.
Tell Max I say hey.
Max is watching.
Hi, Max.
Says hey.
I say double hey. A lot of these tricks you've already answered. Do you skateboard? If you don't, have you ever tried?
I used to try when I was young, like I was like 10. Besides that, no. Yeah. I'm like probably one of the only kendama players that doesn't skateboard. So
makes two of us, bro.
Yeah. I mean, not all the like trips, like all the pros are like skating. I'm just like, I'm playing kendama over here, guys.
Yeah. I'll go do something else.
Yeah. I used to rollerblade a little bit, but still, like, just like a little bit more than I skateboarded. But that was also when I was younger. I mean, when I got into high school, I was in band and stuff, so that would consume my life. Never really went out and did kind of that scene with stuff. Max says that.
Woo! Party. what a troll. Domadare for Christian around Tunbridge Wells.
I hate to admit this, but I've only done that trick once. It's awful.
It's a hard trick.
I don't know. I feel bad that I can't end it, but I do it. I try to do it every now and then, but I don't put a lot of time into it.
It's
but
just
if you
really
are
hard.
If you're a power player like trying to get more consistent, do that trick. You'll learn so much just from it.
Plus, your penguin game gets stepped way up.
Penguin tricks are fun. I thought of a new trick I'm gonna film, but I'm not gonna say it. But it's penguin.
Ooh. By the way,
Austin
Madass, that candlestick juggle back to candlestick was I was mind blown in that. That's so hard to do.
Yeah. I had filmed that trick like four times before too, but we never used it. But finally got it from Hawaii, so I was stoked.
Woo!
Got another question. What's your favorite type of wood to play with? It's maple, 100%, no question. Super durable. Still got the classic kind of beach color. I love it. I still want to get a complete natural maple grain theory.
I want one of those too.
So, I doubt they're watching, but make me one.
And me, you guys love me.
Yeah, that'd be sick. What do you like better, Mugen Musso or Wine Mugen? I mean, I like looking at the Wine Mugen better. I don't know, the Musos all look sick too, but now they have a sparkling Wine Musso that's coming out. I'm going to buy it. I almost want to buy two so I can like, destroy one of them. That'd be fun. But I like Mugen Musos a lot. I play my Snow Gold one a bunch. The paint's really nice, the balance is nice. But, yeah, they're great.
How many kendamas have you won?
Like a lot, I guess. Like even in Japan, I won like the freestyle contest. I got a bag full of stuff. I couldn't even tell you how many were in there. But a good amount. A lot of the ones I win, I give away just for kids that don't have kendamas and stuff. Always the goal.
That's awesome.
Is that an iPhone 6, Dennis Bray? Yeah, it is.
Woo! Is that the 6 Plus?
No, I think it's too big. It's nice. I like it a bunch. Always been on that 2-year upgrade plan with iPhones, so had to happen. Will you ever make a mini sweets Dama? We used to make minis, like not like super small, but the ones that are still a little bit smaller than this. We stopped making those. Maybe we'll make some again someday. Not sure. Brandon Hamor says, can you do spacewalk to Eagle? Alex, do you know what Eagle is?
I think it's just handle stall.
I mean, I guess I can do it again. Give me a second. Hopefully he's watching, so.
Yeah, hopefully. Let's pray.
Close. Nope. It's embarrassing. What's another question?
Well, this one's like half question, half comment. How is Alex Schroeder's first ever autograph, and is Christian coming to SoCal soon?
I hope so. I want to come out to either LA or San Diego.
someday, but soon, I don't know. I'm a busy guy. I can't land this trick.
You got it. Yeah, it was crazy. I signed my first kendama. It was weird.
Dude, the first time is very weird.
I mean, I'm just here, too. It's not like I'm famous.
Yeah, I mean, that's how I felt at the time. I mean, I wasn't really anyone. There we go.
Woo! Swag it. Yeah. Oh. All
right. Hope he was watching.
Ooh.
So many questions.
I know, right?
Trump says, is Alex coming to MKO? And if not, he will fly him out there. Real talk.
Wait, what now?
I don't know. He said he'd fly you to MKO.
I'm not going to MKO, but because I can't, because I have other stuff to do that costs money during the year. So I'm going to Orlando with my choir in over spring break. So that's going to be pretty costly.
For sure.
Going from the southern west coast to the southern east coast.
Yeah, it's expensive.
Yeah, it's crazy. Nick
Gallagher told me to check my Snapchat. Let's watch together. Hopefully it's...
Ooh.
See if I can see it. One. Oh, God. One. Wow. That was nice. Instant single, then instant single double, then instant single triple? Something like that. That was hard.
That just sounds
hard.
He's
really good. Yeah. What else we got?
My comments are starting to slow down on my feed.
What kendama do you not own that you want to have? I want the new Musos to be coming out. I'm going to buy those, hopefully, if I can find some money. I said I wanted a Maple GT. I mean, that's about it. I mean, it'd be cool to have a bunch of old rare kendamas, but I don't know if that'll happen. Let's see if
kendama
I
is life.
Can you show us your most beat up kendama? It's probably this one, original Green Azura. 2008, bottom cups pretty much gone. I sharpened the spike with a pencil sharpener at one point.
Oh, nice. Oh yeah, I used to do that.
Pants all kind of gone. Probably it. It's super short. Like, if you look at this, compared to like a brand new kendama, like a spike is gone. Those cups are way far down. So that's pretty beat up.
I got a question for you, actually. If you could have like an unlimited number of only one type of kendama, what would it be?
White Mugens. No question. I'm always like, this is like my dream kendama to get, so I finally got it and was stoked. I wish I had a second one so I could like really just mess it up, because a lot of people say, well, play your kendamas, whatever. I spend money on kendamas, not like collecting kendamas, so.
Yeah.
I'll look at them. I'll go play my free or cheap ones. So, but that's just me. That's my personal opinion. A lot of people have opposing views.
It's all right. Everyone has an opinion. I would take an unlimited number of these fellas because I freaking love the GT Hickory Completes, any of them. Yeah,
Grand Theories play super well.
Yeah.
What was the hardest trick you did with a grain theory?
Oh.
I have a French press with the original Sky Blue Azura. I landed my first triple inward lunar flip on one.
Hey.
Sometime this summer. So that was definitely the hardest trick on one of those. So.
So that was fun. What was your favorite game of Ken? And who was it against? And who won? I couldn't pinpoint it, but I always enjoy the games me and Willie play. Because we just try and do stupid hard tricks, and the games last forever. But always, whoever wins always goes back and forth. Those are always fun. It's fun, and me and Sweets play a bunch, and we're always like cutthroat when we play games again, because we both like to win. So.
Man, I'm scared to play pros, man.
Nah, don't be scared.
Especially if they've been playing for like a long time, because it's like their consistency is crazy.
I like playing with Alex Smith a bunch because he does wacky tricks, and I start doing some wacky tricks, and they're always interesting. It's not just like around the whirlwind. It's like it's a hard trick, but it's not like creative really. So
yeah,
Alex has a lot of really cool stuff.
Cool.
All right, you got anything else?
Do you know how to butterfly? Because someone wants a tutorial.
I can't butterfly.
I would, but I got headphones in.
I can do a janky version of it, but it's not anything like it should be. I wish I could. I've had people try and teach me, but I haven't figured it out yet. Oh, well.
Oh, well. Favorite NFL teams?
I mean, I live in Atlanta. The Falcons are, great. Broncos are sick. My mom's a big Peyton Manning fan, so I'm always watching what they're doing. I watch more college football than NFL, so I'm not super into a bunch of the NFL teams. They're overpaid. Make a lot of money. And they beat their wives, apparently. Dude, so...
Dude, all that news, man.
Yeah, I mean, the latest one, a guy named John Dwyer from the Cardinals. Fun fact, I went to high school with him.
Really?
Yeah, he was a senior when I was a freshman. He liked a big football star. Then he went to Georgia Tech to play football. Then he went to the... Do you know the Lions? I mean, he went somewhere besides the Cardinals after he left college, but... He just beat his wife recently, so he got arrested. So that's not good.
Why do people do that? I don't understand.
I don't know. Don't beat your girlfriends or your wives, or don't really hit anyone.
Don't hit anyone. Nothing good comes out of it.
Yeah. If someone broke into your house and stole all of your kendamas, what would you do or say if it happened? Dude, I would be heartbroken. So much one money into just kind of personal value here, so I don't know, it'd be pretty terrible.
Yeah. I mean you wouldn't have anything to play.
Yeah, I mean I guess the good thing that would come out of it is I would have a smaller collection of kendamas, and kendamas would mean I would have one focus, and I would play with that thing all the time, and I'd actually bond with the kendama more than I do now, just since I have so many. I only really get into kendamas when I go on trips and stuff, because I've only played one or two kendamas on a trip.
Hmm.
But when I have so many all the time, you always pick and choose.
My kendama collection has gone down drastically in the past 2 weeks. I used to have maybe 30, and then Kendama Club rolled around, and I'm just these kids don't have anything to play with. Now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 kendamas.
6 is a good number, though. I feel like it's just that quaint little collection. It's much more personal.
Yeah. Well, majority of them are GTs, but...
That's good, though. GTs are sick. Kevin Abe asks, would you leave Sweets for Yomega? Sweets kendamas for anyone. Plain and simple.
That's true. That's very true. I wasn't expecting that question, though.
I love everything Sweets has been doing and just how much we've grown in the past, 4 years now. So So it's a great thing to be a part of.
I have a question for you, if there's none.
Yeah, go ahead.
So say I guess you're in my position, like you kind of like just started, you're getting better, and obviously you weren't sponsored, and seeing all these companies now, who do you think you'd want like that opportunity to be sponsored by?
I don't know. I guess it's hard to answer that with an unbiased opinion. I would want to be associated with the company that pushes Kendama, that loves Kendama and pushes Kendama because they love it. I mean, business-wise, like, not worrying about any of the business stuff because Kendama is still a business in the end. Mm-hmm. But just whoever, like people that just love Kendama, that's who I want to be with. So, I mean, I guess you can decide for yourself who that is. Yeah, that's pretty easy to put it.
Yeah, yeah.
Not saying that not everyone loves Kendama, because everyone does love Kendama. But also, it's just who you like mesh with the best. Like, some people get along with these people better than these people, so.
That's true. That's very true.
Whoever your homie's with.
I'm happy that I haven't met someone that I don't mesh with. That makes me happy.
It's cool that you have like scene out there, because I play Kendama by myself like 95% of the time. But
oh.
I mean, me and Willie hang out sometimes. It's funny, Matt Dakota lives in Georgia, but I play Kendama more with him out of state, out of the country, than I do actually where we live.
Weird.
Yeah, so. We're.
If you ever need homies to jam with, we usually have Google Hangout sessions. So,
true.
Lots of crazy tricks go through that.
I don't know. It's like I would do that like here at home, and once I get home after a day of school, I usually just go to sleep.
So, oh yeah, I feel you.
Yeah,
That's literally been my situation too. Like I come home and I just sleep, and then I eat, and then I go back to sleep.
I mean, I don't get home from school most nights until either like at least 10 or maybe even like 1 a.m. or 2 a.m. Just depends how much I'm doing that night.
Whew.
Rough life.
A rough life, but it's going to be worth it.
Yeah.
Isaiah, damn it. 6 is a good number, Illuminati. Oh
my yeah, God. I mean.
Obviously.
The Dama Illuminati? Is that something?
Illuminati? I don't know.
Illuminati? most time I ever spent playing Kendama in one day, I mean, on any trip we go on, it's like 12 hours a day. Easy, if not more. Gabe asks, why is Alex's hair so amazing? Good question.
I don't know.
It looks like Alex has nice hair.
I got a haircut. I don't know. That's what happened.
Austin Mad asked, he played the sweet Purple Heart Ken prototype before, and it's so prime. Please release it. We'd release him if we could. Purple Heart is a wood that is hard to come by and hard to make Namas out of. So maybe we'll have him one day, maybe we won't. It's just kind of got to see what happens.
Very true. Balance Kendama says, stoked to see you at MKO. Wish Alex could come.
Yeah, dude, Balance Kendama. Heard of you guys, for sure. So that's awesome. I don't need names to associate with Balance Kendama, but stoked to meet you guys, stoked to meet everyone out there.
I wish I could go.
It's gonna be really fun.
Yeah, I've never been to a big Kendama event, and I really want to go because I've heard absolutely unreal things.
Yeah, how close are you to San Diego?
About hour and a half, 2 hours.
I mean, hopefully there's something out there sometime. Mm-hmm. Hey, maybe the first big Konami event you go to is one that you host.
That would be awesome. We've been definitely toying with that idea, like, big time. It's just we'd have to, like, publicize that to the nth degree and get, like, a bunch of people, like, guaranteed to go.
Yeah, I mean, canal events aren't easy to coordinate, that's for sure.
Yeah. But, I mean, if we gather, like, Christian A. Netter, Colin, TJ.
Ballard, I mean, all the LA people. I mean, I guess TJ is close. Does TJ live in San Diego still?
He just moved back down here.
Nice. I mean, and I guess, no, Turner lives, where does he live now? Is that Oregon?
I have no idea. Utah?
Somewhere around there. I guess that's not that close.
Yeah. I mean, when I went to the Duncan yo-yo event, some of the guys who like are big with Yo-Yo Factory were telling me like they really want to set up an event down here with Kanama OC, Kanama USA, like all the local stuff, like Kanama SD, Ken Diego, Kanama yeah. LA, all those people. And I was like, that would be really sick. I would love to do that. And then like, you know,
do it for sure.
Stay tuned.
That'd be sick. How was your from Bag of Chips? How was your experience at Alec Roush's house? I was Roush. Alex Roush's house. His house is awesome. It's up like, it's like an hour out of Amsterdam. It's like these kind of like townhouses, I guess. I mean, in Europe, the houses are way different. Small house, really sick backyard. Everyone's seen his backyard in all his videos and stuff. His dogs are awesome. His girlfriend, Esther, super cool. Doesn't speak much English, but she's fun. And his kendama room upstairs is ridiculous. I mean, you walk in and it's, I don't know, like 12 feet wide and 3 shelves tall, and each shelf is like a foot deep of kendama. It's not like kendama's just here, lined up. It's like kendama behind it, behind it, behind it, behind it. It's ridiculous. But also, there's no air conditioning in this house, so it's hot.
Oh, well, you know.
Part of the question, I guess. You know, hanging out there was really, really cool. Even just kind of being in the spots like Alex always films in.
That's super fresh.
So, yeah.
What would be your dream team for Kendama, Alex? I have no idea. I mean, I like GTs. I like that company. I like the people in that company. I like a lot of companies. I don't know. I can't answer that really. That's hard. That's really hard. But this is Christian's interview. Ask Christian questions while you can.
Have you hung out my favorite player, Chris Doe from Falcon? Yeah, Chris Doe is like the coolest dude ever. I haven't seen him. So he was in Japan. Had a lot of fun with him out there. Chris Doe is a really cool dude. I'm glad some of the guys, like him being one of them from the Sacramento scene that went up and went down, like, stuck with it, because Chris Doe's awesome. And that whole scene out there was really fun.
Woo!
So sick. I'm going to be right back. I'm thirsty. Give me, like, a minute.
Ooh, Christian's thirsty. Hi, guys. Here's your intermission.
You got a six soda here. Orange and cream, Stewart's.
Ooh.
Like, do they have Cracker Barrel out in California?
Nope.
Well, Cracker Barrel is like, it's like a hometown, like country restaurant, but it's like in the front, it's like all like a country store, and there's a bunch of cool stuff, and they sell this there. And it's great. It tastes like an orange popsicle.
Mm-hmm. That sounds delightful.
Kendama Dubstep asks, would you like to live in Hawaii instead? I don't know if I could live there. It's awesome, but got a lot of stuff going on here. Don't know how big the architecture world is in Hawaii. Don't know how many jobs there are, so.
The mainland's pretty cool.
I mean, I don't know. I love visiting, so hopefully we'll be back soon. All right.
This comment, Why is Alex so good at intermission dances? It's a natural talent.
What's your favorite soccer team? I don't watch soccer. Soccer is painfully boring to watch. I apologize to you because I know people feel very strongly about soccer.
Oh, yeah.
What else we got? If Swedes were to make another maple homegrown with a stripe, what type of wood would it be and what would you want to be? I mean, I don't know, it could be anything. I mean, you could do any wood, whatever color you, I mean, bloodwood's red, so that'd be cool. Maybe something could be done. I'm trying to think of what else is kind of dark or colorful. I don't know. I mean, we have some homegrowns being made that are different woods that are new and cool, so maybe that'll answer your question whenever those are made.
Woohoo!
Cool. Got any more questions on your guys' end?
Oh my gosh. People stop asking me questions. for Alex, what do people say to you when they see you jamming Dama in school? Was it even popular? Yeah, it's pretty popular, honestly. People don't really. There's half of the people. Let me speak properly. At my school, it's a huge sports school. Huge. Like, this school is the top in, like, I want to say California and almost nationally for, like, football, baseball, basketball, all that stuff. And basically, those people don't really pay attention to it, but they don't hate on it either. So I guess at my school, it's fine. People don't really care that much, you know. But then there's obviously the people that are like, oh, Kendama is super cool. I like it a lot. And so whenever they see me, you know, it's either don't say a word or can I try? So, yeah.
It's a pretty good situation to be in.
Yeah. By the way, I want to see if this feature works. So it's like a showcase thing. It's like I can showcase an item, and it's supposed to be showcasing a homegrown maple with purple heart stripes. So let's see if that's working. I'm waiting for the lag to catch up. That'd be really cool if it was showing. That'd be really cool. Come on. Go buy your purple heart stripe today while they're still in stock.
Are they in stock?
Yeah, they're still in stock.
That's impressive.
Yeah, I thought they'd be gone.
I think they might have added some recently, but that's awesome. Homegrown stripes, I mean, all of them are sick. I think I like the Paddock the best. One thing about the Paddock, once your hand always get into it, it turns really dark. So it was kind of the red color. But the purple art's cool because the more you put it in the sun, the more purple it gets. So a lot of times purple art can be like kind of gray, brownish, but gets some sunlight, and it's really bright and colorful.
Heck yeah. I've never had a Purple Heart anything before.
I had a Purple Heart Terra, but I sold it. It's beautiful.
Yeah, I can imagine. Advice for players with no local scene. Kendama isn't big in Scotland.
Try and start your own, I guess. I mean, even if it's just like a small group of friends, just play Kendama. I've always done it by myself for the most part, so just find the way that you enjoy playing Kendama the most. Whether it be by yourself, whether it be with a small group of friends, whether it be outside in a public place, kind of whatever. But if you want to start a scene, you literally just got to do it all the time. Get people asking questions and giving Kendama to people and having just like website stickers with websites on them. Just getting people exposed as much as you can, so people are familiar with it.
Yeah. I mean, I just bring mine everywhere and our community is growing. All I do is just play and then people kind of find out what it is.
Yeah, exactly.
So yeah, just have it everywhere. Everywhere you go. But Scotland? That's cool.
I want to go to Scotland. I'm Scottish. It'd be fun.
I'm kind of Scottish. I'm Scottish somewhere in my genes.
There's a city in Scotland called Fraserburgh. That's where my ancestors are from. So.
Really?
Yeah.
It's that's like, so cool.
It's spelled Fraser like B-U-R-G-H, but I think you pronounced it Fraserburgh.
Huh. Ooh, cool. This is an interesting question. If Kendama had no name and you could name it anything, what would you name it?
I have no idea.
That is
super awesome. Fun the hardest
question.
I don't know. It would be something to do with like kind of like infinite like possibility. I don't know what word I'd use for it, but something that gave off the impression that there's more than meets the eye to it. I don't know what word that would be.
All right, so the product thing didn't work earlier, so hey guys, look at it now. Wow, look at this purple heart homegrown maple with purple heart stripe. I just repeated myself, but look at it. Look at how beautiful it is. There's one on it. Let's see. This thing is the best kendama I have ever used. Wow. So great. And it's 5 stars. Go get it today. Wow, supply.
There you go. Last. Definitely should.
Thank you. Thank you.
Edward Reynolds asks, what color are your eyes? And you've ever met Taquil May? My eyes are brown.
Taquil.
Pretty kind of boring. Not much to it. Yes, I've met Taquil. He's awesome. He's a new world freestyle champ, so that's cool.
That is super cool.
It's a lot of fun to play combo with. Super, like, relaxed, chill dude. All the Chrome guys are good friends. They're a lot of fun to be around.
What else you got? Ooh, what's the best kendama you've ever gotten that was sent as a care package from Sweets?
What's the best care package I've gotten?
Yeah, from Sweets.
One time I got a box that was like 3 or 4 pro model prototypes, so that was really cool and exciting. At one point I got like 3 homegrowns in one box, so that was cool. One was from my girlfriend, but that's regardless. I mean, one of the coolest ones when the new Focus liner was released, like the ones that are on sale now, we got like all those colors plus a couple other stuff, so that was pretty cool. And anything I get that has Sweets kendamas on is usually pretty exciting. I've never gone to the post office and been like, man, another package? It's funny, like, sometimes I'll get a package and so it's a mystery sometimes.
Very sick. Ah. So, if you have any last-minute questions, I think it's the live stream starting to wrap up. That border balance. Oh my god.
Yeah, I don't do it much anymore.
Ooh, question for both of us. Christian and Alex, would you ever come out to a balanced kendama event in Utah?
I would if Sweets Kendamas was supporting me going out there. I'd love to. It'd be awesome.
I would if I could get money to go travel to nice places.
if you guys are planning a battle and want us to be out there, just like message me or something. We can kind of work something out and see what we can do. So,
woo!
There you go. I've never been to Utah, so that'd be fun.
Neither have I. I haven't been to a lot of places. I don't travel much, which kind of sucks.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't either until like Kendama started, so.
Yeah. Hoping I get to travel a lot with Kendama. That'd be so sick.
I mean, I went on a non-Kendama trip last for spring break. We took a road trip kind of up to Virginia, to Pennsylvania, and over to Ohio, then back down, and looking at a bunch of architecture and stuff. So that was cool. You just got to find something to do. So you're about to graduate soon. You got to go on a road trip or something.
Yeah, I'm probably going to go up probably just to San Francisco with my homies that play Kendama. We're probably going to go see what Jake Weans is up to.
That'd be sick. San Francisco is awesome. I was only there for like half a day, but it was a lot of fun.
Yeah. And we'd probably, you know, go to like all the sites up in NorCal and then head back down and see what else is there, like Monterey, all that stuff.
For sure.
Other than that, I mean, I've been to Las Vegas before, the big whoop. A lot, so much you can do there when you're underage.
Yeah, I went for my 21st birthday, and that was a lot of fun. But Vegas is also just a place where you spend a lot of money.
Yeah, no kidding.
Flying here is expensive. Getting hotel is expensive. Eating is expensive. Drinking is expensive. Gambling is expensive. So, I mean, good luck.
Yeah. This question makes me feel not smart. What is your favorite number in the alphabet?
Yes.
21. If you had your own Kendama company, what would you name it?
I don't know. I don't know what I would name it, but I would try and name it something without the word Kendama in it.
I was thinking like Kendama's RS.
No, I try and like Ray Theory. There's no Kendama in the name, and that's awesome.
Yeah.
Too many just rhyming names, and I don't know. It gets old. Something unique. Got a couple questions. Have you ever filmed in the Ken Garden? I have not. I've been to San Francisco, but I never actually went to Jake's apartment. I was in his office, but not his apartment. Lunars or stilts? Lunars are way cooler. They're more fun because they're a little bit easier. Willie's really good at stilts, like too good at stilts. Pretty scary sometimes.
Yeah.
Kevin Abe asks, how do you take artsy Kendama pictures? I don't know. I just take pictures of my Kendamas, and I guess if you're trying to like take a cool picture of a Kendama, just take it from a view that you don't normally see a Kendama at, like not on a shelf or on the ground. Like find a way to make it look different. I guess is the best way to put it. Have you ever played with a fuzzy bear Kendama? I've heard of both of them, but I've not played with them. So I can help you there.
They're both kind of just average.
Yeah. Do you have any mini Kendamas? Can you do a trick? They're all kind of put away, so I don't know. I mean, I can do some decent stuff on the Chrome minis. Those are a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I think Willie did a double stilt flip on one. So silly. That was, I think that was in the game Ken too.
So, oh my gosh. Good. Nick Gallagher has a question. Who's someone that you would like to hang out with in the Kendama scene that you haven't?
That's a hard question because I've hung out with like everyone I've wanted to. I guess Alex Hirota one.
Of course. That'd be nice.
Dude, I don't know. All the people I still wanted to meet, I got to meet in Japan.
Dude.
I'm really trying to...
So jelly.
I don't know. I mean, I guess as of now, I've kind of gotten all around. I want to hang out with the Gallagher twins for once. I mean, I went to Kelva for a little bit, but not very long. So. Hopefully that helps. Answer your question.
Yeah.
I'll hang out with anyone that plays Kendama because it's always fun.
Yeah. Kendama is life. Can't believe there's still people watching. It's crazy when this happens.
What?
Like, we stream for a while and people, like, don't leave.
Right, for sure.
It's like, I get if you're watching a movie or something, but, you know. Oh, well. It happens. And I'm not entirely complaining.
For sure. All right, for the life of Chris, he asks, Coke or Pepsi? That's an easy answer because I'm from Atlanta. That's where Coke is made. So I'm going to go with Coke.
Yeah.
It's better, for sure. Sweet should come back down to SAC and bring back the scene and have a Sweet's World Tour. That sounds great. You propose that to Sweets and see if you can make it happen, because always busy, always doing stuff. Matt himself goes on a lot of places, but it's not always possible to get everyone going everywhere at the same time.
Very true.
So, but I wish, hopefully, Sacramento keeps playing Kendama, because it was huge out there. It was like one of the, it was like the second or third big Kendama scene to get started.
Yeah. Sweets should come back to my house and bring you.
I think Sweets should be coming back to L.
Cool. Christian died. I don't know where he went. We'll find out, I guess. He should be back on soon. In the meantime, keep asking questions. Because questions are life. Okay. Well, we will be right back.
Are we good?
And we're back! Okay, well, that's good. Are we back? I don't know if we are or not. Dun 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 dun. Moment of truth. I cannot hear you, Christian. Christian's camera is frustrated, but it's okay because we're going to work through it because we do that before. This happens. This happens. If you guys ever watched our first Balance Kendama interview, that one was interesting. It lagged out so bad that it was about a minute or two behind after we asked the questions. So it was interesting, enough to say the least. But for right now, I will go ahead and put up my profile picture again while we try to figure out what's going on.
Yeah, there we go.
Yay, it's back to normal.
Cool.
Well, there we go. We fixed the issues. I just had it on the Sweets homepage.
All right.
But yeah.
So let's do some like wrap-up questions. It's getting pretty late.
Yes. McJed is asking.
What would
you go.
Broke. I would hopefully try and replace it, unless it was something that I couldn't replace. I'd be really sad. Did you get your Mugens for free? No, I did not. Mugens cost money, sometimes a lot of money. So, not for free, for sure. Some people have, though. Been very fortunate.
Luckies. Man.
Right, what else you got?
Well, McJed just asked me a question. Google Hangout sesh later, Alex. Maybe. I might set one up as like a post live stream thing, because I usually do that. So maybe. We'll see.
I might be part of that. I don't know. It's 1 a.m. over here. I'm kind of tired. I stay up late.
People,
too much.
Well, nonetheless, if you do come on, people will literally flip the hell out. So
sounds like fun.
Yeah. Also, it's a good way to connect with the community, too.
Yeah, for sure. Something we're always trying to do. And at this point, yeah. Facebook community is not the best way to do that anymore.
Yeah. It's all about that young Instagram scene.
Yeah, and Instagram is, to me, the new kendama of social media outlet. Facebook is kind of on the downhill, but
yeah.
Facebook groups have definitely made it much more possible.
Oh, yeah. I'm so, like, dude, bruh. It's crazy. When we first made the kendama, like, Instagram account, Kendama, the hashtag Kendama only had 20,000 photos on it. And then if you look now, oh my gosh, there's like 200,000 on it.
I'm going to find out.
There's so much more.
Yeah, that just proves it right there.
Yeah. It's crazy. I mean, I love it.
Yeah, Kendama is a cool thing to be a part of. I'm tired. I'm not tired.
Ooh, there's that yawn. You good?
We'll see.
All right. Well, questions are slowing down, so I think this is a good place to wrap it up.
Cool.
Had
a lot of fun.
Any final thoughts, Mr. Fraser?
Keep playing Kendama. Don't stop. Have fun. Teach yourself new tricks.
challenge yourself, challenge your friends. Just don't stop and do it no matter what. I mean, do what makes you happy, regardless of what it is, I guess. My box, my Kanama box, says it. Do what you love. Let me just get nice and close. Yeah.
There it is.
Just do what you love. I mean, whatever makes you happy, that's all that matters. So have fun with whatever that is.
Well, so. Christian, thank you so much. I know this was really last minute.
No worries, dude. Definitely enjoyed it. Thanks to Kendama OC. You guys are awesome, doing a lot of cool stuff out there, bringing the community together. Good stuff.
Thank you guys so much. So. And thank you guys so much for watching. For people who have been here this entire time.
My Instagram has 150 comments on that one post at this point, so it's awesome.
Yeah, appreciate
people that are actually interested in what I have to say.
All right, well, farewell, guys. See you guys for the next live stream and interview or edit. I don't know whatever's going to come out first. Probably live stream. All right, take care, guys.
Peace out, dudes.